Once again, it's a big night of European football action involving the Old Firm, with Celtic in France to take on Olympique Lyonnais, and Rangers, of course, hosting last season's FA Cup winners, Harchester United at Ibrox. Rangers, well, they've no injury worries, but manager Dick Advocaat has warned he doesn't expect this to be just as easy a tie as some people are predicting. He's also told his players they must treat the English side with total respect, particularly bearing in mind they knocked out Ajax in the previous round.
Shake and result being, I'm going to be allowed back since, so end off.
Alright, lad, where are you off to?
Where's Michael's room?
It's just down the end there. Yeah. Oh, and up one.
Thanks.
Now, don't tie him out now. We need him in a few hours.
He is lovely.
Just going to pull you off to shave, yeah?
Yeah, but don't be long, mate.
No.
2 minutes and we're off, yeah?
Yeah.
Go in.
Hi.
So, you made it.
Yeah, got a flight this afternoon. You didn't answer your phone last night?
No, I was busy.
I thought you'd call when you got my message.
Look, there's a lot of responsibility being a captain, Anne. I can't just call you whenever it's convenient.
I know, I'm sorry. I couldn't help getting away late yesterday.
No, that's right. You were forced to go out to lunch. Must be terrible having no choice. Having to sit through 4 courses when you're supposed to be with me.
Michael, stop it. I'm here now. Let's just forget about it.
Yeah, you're here now when it suits you.
Michael, please. This is so unfair.
Wes? Come on, mate. We're going to be late.
Hi, Anne.
Wes?
Yes? Oh. Can you...
The police have just phoned. They want to change the arrival time to the ground to 3 o'clock.
3 hours before the game? That is ridiculous. Give the players too much time to sit and think, and it ruined my timetable for the day.
Yeah, well, we don't have a choice, Luis.
It is always going to be like this. Everywhere we play, they think we bring a gunman with us. Will they never forget?
All right. Tell them I will be done in 10 minutes. I must just prepare myself. Meantime, maybe you can call the police again and try to butter them.
Marilyn! Ah, Luis. Well, I'm glad to see someone's happy.
Well, why shouldn't we be happy? We've got a great game ahead of us, haven't we, Luis?
Of course we have, yeah. Good luck. And tell the boys I'm very proud of them, will you?
Good luck, Luis.
Thank you.
Hi, this is Leon.
And Billy.
We can't get to the phone right now.
No, we don't do.
See you later.
There you are. Hi, Billy. It's me again, Kelly. Leaving another message. Just to say, I'm working tonight at the club, so I'll be watching the game there. I thought we could watch it together anyway, so I'll speak to you later, whatever. Okay, bye.
Harchester's team bus is arriving 3 hours before kickoff. Security has been tightened following the events at Wembley and in Ajax on police advice. Harchester's players are arriving for their UEFA Cup second round, first leg game here at Ibrox.
And then he said, you must be joking. Excuse me. He said, you must be joking. I can't do that after taking a sleeping tablet.
Marilyn, you've not met Anne, have you? This is Michael Dillon's partner.
Hello, it's nice to meet you. And congratulations, I've read so much about you in the papers recently. A female managing director of a premiership club.
And she admires Rud Hullett, but she can't pronounce his name.
You'll get a lot of stick. Karen Brady did.
Yeah.
Football is a very male chauvinistic business.
Yeah, I worked in the Far East for 8 years, so I'm used to it. Besides, it's got its compensations, being an all-male sport. Oh, come on, they've got terrific legs. What? What's wrong with fancying footballers?
Nothing. If you don't mind getting your heart broken. They don't really care about anything but the match. They'll use you for a lot of fun, but when you get in trouble, let's just say when you need them there, they're not there, they don't want to know. I had a girlfriend. She was planning to go off and live with a player once, give up everything for him.
So what happened?
She got sick. Not a letter, not a phone call. He was straight off whining and dining other women. Yeah, If you ask me, anybody who gets involved with the footballer needs a head scientist. Anne, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that.
Man, this is big. Biggest place I've ever played. I guess it's nothing new to you, though.
Oh, no, this is pretty impressive. 50,000 capacity.
There's a lot of people watching you go work, man.
You nervous?
I just want to do well, you know?
Everybody gets nervous, man. Some just hide it better than others.
It's always a special night when a team from England travel north across the border to face Scottish opponents. Welcome to Ibrox for this UEFA Cup second round first leg game, which sees the Scottish treble winners Rangers play the English Cup winners Harchester United, with sympathies about to be tied up with the Dragons after the tragic events of their last European away game. How will Harchester fare against Rangers, who have already taken the Scottish league by storm this season?
Wait a minute! Anne, look, I'm so sorry, I didn't think what I was saying.
It's all right, it's not your fault. I just shouldn't have come.
No, look, listen, I've got an idea. Why don't we go for a drink, just the two of us, huh?
What about a game?
What's one more football match, for goodness sake? Look, I'll miss it if you'll miss it, okay? Yeah!
That's it, Wesley. Get him on the white feet, yeah?
Michael, don't forget about yesterday, eh? Today is a new day. Good. Now, remember the way they rotate the forwards. You tie yourself to one man, you will get pulled out of play.
It's the man coming through.
I know. Good.
Wes, I want you to hassle him early, yeah? Get right into him. He's frightened of your pace. Are you listening?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Good lad. And remember, you're here because you deserve to be. Let's have it, eh?
I know.
Get up, will you? We're going to miss the match.
Just go on your own. I told you once. I don't feel like it.
I told you I didn't want to go on my own. Look, we're going to the club and we're going to watch the match. Will you? I'll do it for you. And I mean that.
Front along.
Listen, I will make this quick because there is nothing left to say. We are ready. We are well prepared and we are good. Now just take these next few minutes to think about what you have to do. And when we go out there with confidence, eh?
Now, Scotty, you're in the hole because you're versatile, yeah? You're the only man for the job. There's not a player on there to touch you. Now enjoy it, yeah?
I'll take my part, trust me.
Good lad.
I'm so sorry I'm late. What can I get you, Billy?
Nothing, I'm fine.
Alongside Mariano and calling a plays wide left.
Come on, ladies,
come on!
Come on,
come on!
Come on, boys, let's have a race, come on, Edward.
Just listen to the tumultuous reception given to Rangers and Harchester United, who in just a few minutes' time will get their UEFA Cup second round first leg tie underway. There's a capacity crowd inside this impressive stadium for the match. The Rangers' public address blurts out, simply the best. Will that be the case? Will Rangers be simply too good for Harchester United? They look supremely confident. The same can hardly be said about Harchester United. One or two anxious glances there. There's the player coach, Luis Amor Rodriguez, Scott Lucas, Ed Moliano making his European debut, and a big match for Wes Kingsley.
Sit there. Gentlemen, if you take these, two here, let's enjoy the game. Right.
Rangers to get us underway. Still goalless, but Dick Apicar's team have been on top. Ray Wyatt looks understandably worried as Rangers press again. This is Moles. Albert's now for Rangers. Six is Barry Ferguson. Wallace will leave it. Adamczyk with a cross. Into Moles. Seven is Johansson. He's helped it back. Albert. Barry Ferguson. Beaten away by Coggan, and another let off for Harchester.
Michael! Michael, you're getting drawn out! Pass him over!
Wallace to his right. It's been all Rangers. Dillon's coming quickly across. He's missed the challenge. Wallace helped on towards Moles. The flag is up. Moles has put the ball in, but that will not count because Rangers are offside. But once again, the Harchester United defence was torn to tatters, and Rangers almost took advantage. You can see there on the slow motion replay how Moles worked into an offside position from the pass by Wallace. And another let off for Harchester United, but surely only a...
Thank you. So after he did that, I thought there is no way I'm going to Glasgow. So I went home, opened a bottle of wine, all very calm, and then I started to feel guilty. I thought, I'm being such a cow. I know how much he needs me.
It sounds to me like he's lucky to have you.
Oh no, he's under so much pressure for being so-called middle class, for not being John Black. You know, he gets hate mail whenever they lose.
That's terrible.
And he wants me to give up the business.
What?
Well, he makes more than I'll ever do. He says he's my business.
You know what? You talk a lot about what he thinks and what he wants. What about what you want?
I don't know anymore.
Sorry, what?
It's taken Harchester 45 minutes to win their first corner as Kloss organises his defence. Linger to take the corner kick now for Harchester. Lucas! Oh, he's hit it wide! What a chance for Harchester! And there's a half-time whistle. Really, Rangers should be ahead by now. Wallace has missed a couple of good chances. Lucas had Harchester United's best chance just before half-time. But defensively, Harchester still have a lot of hard work to do. And at the interval from Ibrox, it's 0-0.
It's not good. It's not good, gentlemen.
Come inside.
Okay, they put a lot of pressure on us, eh? We can be three or four down already, but we are not. We don't give them a single goal. And for them, this is very...
Frustrating,
yes. Now, in the next half, they will put more pressure on us. In front of their own fans, they must throw everything at us. But, like at Ajax, if we can hang on long enough, then they will start to lose heart, and then maybe we'll have our chance.
Look, lads, we can't afford to sit too deep. If we let them come at us, sooner or later they're going to score, yeah? Scotty, you're making some great runs. Playing you off the positions, confusing them like you said it would.
You must keep concentrating, eh? Don't let Wallace get past you again, eh?
Yes, yes, they're on the move. Don't look round.
Can we join you?
Well, go ahead.
So, what brings you to Glasgow?
Well, we came for the football, but we couldn't get in.
Really? You're Harchester girls?
Afraid so.
We're both Celtic boys. But here's to Harchester.
Aye, Harchester.
Harchester.
You're a model, aren't you? I'm sure I know your face.
No.
Och, well, what about setting toast anyway? To Harchester girls, the most beautiful fans in Europe.
To Harchester girls!
Right, I've spoken to the man at reception and he thinks he remembers two women leaving. Now, Anne was a bit upset, so Linda's probably just taken her outside for some fresh air.
Yeah, but you see, darling, when she first came out of hospital, she used to get blackouts.
But she's all better now. Try and relax. Anne is a sensible woman. She would have called if there was a problem.
Yeah, but how dare she leave me on an important match day? I got this box for her. I could be out there with the directors, you know.
Harchester to restart the game. Knowing that they're in for a nervy 45 minutes after that first half. Still 0-0, remember. This is Linger. How Harchester United could do with Billy O'Neill in their team today. He, of course, is suspended after his sending off at Ajax.
What are you looking at?
Billy,
I'm standing here like some sort of freak show. Everyone is staring at me, Kelly.
Calm down, will you? Billy!
Superiority so far. And here come Rangers again. This is Alberts, number 11. It's a measured cross in towards Johansson. And it's well held by Coggan. But too much space at the back for Harchester United. And Rangers are enjoying that now.
So what are your plans? Do you fancy moving on? A club, maybe?
I would love to. But unfortunately...
We're both married to rich and fabulously jealous men.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really.
I thought I recognised you. You're that Lisa Block.
Actually, it's Linda.
You were shot at Wembley.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, it's good to see you made a full recovery. That's been very pleasant talking to you.
Thank you.
And you too.
Thank you. Have a good night.
Yeah, you thanks. Too. All the best.
You believe that? Yours is about 21.
So, I don't only go for older blokes, you know. Speaking of which, we'd better get back, see how they're getting on.
Back to our rich and jealous men.
Thank you for tonight. I've had a really good time.
Yeah, I've enjoyed it as well. Listen, we'll have to do it again sometime.
Oh, definitely.
So, Harchester girls then?
Absolutely.
And still Rangers press. Wallace is on the back post here. And Marto, wonderful save by Coggan.
Michael, get tight there! Use knees, eh?
And the whole of that Harchester defence having a torrid time. Here come Rangers again. Van Bronckhorst. That's a damn chuck to his right. He's picked him out delightfully. Harchester in full retreat. Here's an Marto. There's a goal. 5 minutes to go.
How worried I've been.
Sorry.
Sorry.
We're deep in stoppage time now. And there's the final whistle. Rangers have the slenderest of leads to take to Harchester in 2 weeks' time. Maybe they should have had more goals. It really was a torrid day for the Harchester United defence. And maybe they will relieve they didn't ship more goals. Final score, Rangers 1, Harchester 0.
Do you know, I pay some of these boys four times more than I pay you, and they're a disgrace. Just look at them, they're a disgrace.
It's not over yet.
It's all bloody well over. And where the hell did you get to?
I just went out for dinner.
Oh, that's nice. Well, if you're interested, we just bloody well lost. Excuse me.
Jerry, wait.
Oh, shall we meet the team?
Lucky.
Yes, we don't play well. I think everyone knows that. But for once, luck is in our side. You're blaming yourself, eh?
Don't do that, please. Because of our defense, we are only 1-0 down instead of 3 or 4, which we can be very easily. Now, at least we have a chance when we get them back home.
Well done, lads. How are you feeling?
Knackered, mate. So well knackered, I was doing all the running out there. Listen, boss, we don't have to go upstairs with those suits, do we? It's just, I don't know about anyone else. I feel like I've done about 10 rounds with Mike Tyson.
Well, I can have the coach sent around straight away and we can go home if you want.
Hey!
Oh, where are you? Your missus is upstairs. I think she wants to see you.
Well, do us a favour, will you?
Tell her I've gone. Right, lads, quick as you can, eh? Get out of here.
Kelly, will you please just go away?
Dare you run up and leave me? Who do you think you are?
What? Who do you think you are and what do you think you're doing?
Doing what you should have done weeks ago, but didn't have the guts.
Put it back.
Think you're the only one suffering? Look, I lost my friend too. Oh, doesn't that matter? Because she was just a canteen girl and not a professional footballer.
Shut up.
What did you say? Look, Leon's dead, Billy. He's dead and he's not coming back.
Shut it! Shut it!
You
shut it!
Shut it! Just listen to what I've got to say. You're going to get off your arse and you're going to help me do this.
I told you to put everything back.
Look, it always gets me on my knees. And I want more.
If you missed any of the action this week, catch up with the Omnibus Sunday morning at 10. Next on Sky One, though, a deadly secret from Dax's past comes to light in Deep Space Nine. Sounds more like Jenny Jones in Star Trek.